Hello friends, I am going to talk about some points to remember while waiting for any miracle, and this is a guideline from the Holy Bible. The passage I have selected from Mark chapter 5 verses 35 to 43, and here we see that Jesus is in a city. While Jesus was still speaking, some people came from the house of Jairus, the synagogue leader. "Your daughter is dead," they said. "Why bother the teacher anymore?" Overhearing what they said, Jesus told him, "Don't be afraid, just believe." He did not let anyone follow him except Peter, James, and John, the brother of James. When they came to the home of the synagogue leader, Jesus saw a commotion, with people crying and wailing loudly. He went in and said to them, "Why all this commotion and wailing? The child is not dead, but asleep." But they laughed at him. After he put them all out, he took the child's father and mother and the disciples who were with him and went in where the child was. He took her by the hand and said to her, "Talitha kumi," which means, "Little girl, I say to you, get up." Immediately the girl stood up and began to walk around. At this they were completely astonished. He gave strict orders not to let anyone know about this and told them to give her something to eat. Here we see that a synagogue leader went to Jesus because his daughter was very ill, very sick. And he is asking him, "The teacher, come to my house and please heal my daughter." So he was waiting for a miracle. He was wanting a miracle in his family. In the same way, we also pray for many things. We ask for many things to God. And when we wait for our miracle, so we have to keep five main points in our mind. The first point is, don't be afraid. Like it is written here, don't be afraid. So we don't have to afraid. We just have to have faith in God, whatever the circumstances are. But we have to be firm and we have to believe. The second point is, just believe, have faith. No doubt should come in our mind. We should keep asking God, and we must have a firm determination in our hearts that whatever we have asked, God will do that. The third point, kick out the negative people like Jesus did. He did not let anyone follow him except Peter, James, and John, the brother of James. Because the crowd, they were laughing at him when he said that the girl is not dead, she is asleep, and they laughed at him. So what did Jesus did? He left all the crowd, all the people outside, and only he took the selected ones. So we have to kick out the negative people from our surroundings. The fourth point, surround yourself with positive people. Here we see, he took the child's father and mother and the disciples who were with him and went in where the child was. So Jesus deleted all the negative people. He did not allow them to come with him. And next, he surrounded himself with only positive people. And the last point is, feed your miracle. Like we see, Jesus asked, "The daughter is now alive. Give her something to eat." Because the Jairus, the synagogue leader, went to God to ask him or to request him to heal his daughter. Jesus healed the daughter, healed the girl, little girl. But when she was alive, he asked him that, "Give her something to eat." Many a times we also ask for many things. We want many things. But when we get those things, when we have those blessings, we don't care about them. We become totally careless about it. So we have to take care of all the blessings what God has given us. If we are asking for anything, we are waiting for anything, we are waiting any a miracle to happen in our lives, and after receiving that miracle, we have to totally look after, totally take care of that miracle, of that blessing, and give all the praise and thanksgiving to God. God bless you all.